one of our best-loved sporting heroes pays tribute to one of the screen's most iconic action heroes, Lara Croft. Dancing the tango, it's Nina Carberry and her pro partner, Pasquale La Rocca.
So this week's movie is going to be Tomb Raider. So we have a tango.
It'll be challenging, but I'm really looking forward to it. There's a lot in the tango that you have to remember. Obviously, we have to keep the character in mind as well. Pasquale says he has a surprise for me. I'd say it's probably more rehearsal time.
So I brought Nina today here to get into character. She needs to become Lara Croft. Oh, my God.
I enjoy all those things, so it was a bit of fun today for me in a way. I'm not sure about for Pasquale though.
That was a bit scary.
Dancing the Tango from the movie Lara Croft Tomb Raider. Nina Carberry and Pasquale La Rocca.
Disconnect your robot there. There's nothing robotic about that dance, though. It was absolutely incredible, wasn't it, guys? Some of you are on your feet. Brilliant.
I was just like, that was so good.
Nina, they say good things come in threes. You have delivered quick step, Roomba, and now the tango. Is there anything you can't do? Seriously. You were so into your character. I was like, oh my God, I wouldn't want to mess with you. So intense, so serious. But I'm so looking forward to see more energetic, fun, and shake your body, you know. Let loose numbers. Another amazing night for Nina.
Thank you.
Brian.
Well, Nina, for the last few weeks I've been singing your praises, but tonight I have a bit of technical advice for you. When you're in these dances that are a little bit lower, you need to control the positions of your feet. If one is pointing east and one is pointing west, it makes the leg lines look a little bit open. Just get them facing the same way. I'm sure Pasquale will help you with that. But good characterization because it didn't overtake the dancing. I love that. So, not your best night, but still pretty good.
Oh, okay.
I enjoyed very much the opening. It was very in, but it was equally out, and you also had, like, the stick fights there as well. But I would have likened to see that in the tango. I felt the tango became too in, too compact, perfect there, the contra check. There's no volume in it, no space. So for me, it was just a little bit empty. Too much in, I needed more out.
Okay, thank you.
They're being tough on you because they really like you. Please give it up for Nina and Pasquale.
Pasquale. say, I mean, I love that. You love that up there.
Yeah, I loved enjoying learning the tango. I wish I had more time to learn it better.
Well, I mean, the journey continues, the adventure continues. You're getting better and better, would you agree?
Oh, I really enjoyed tonight. I thought it was brilliant to play a character in a dance. It was brilliant.
And last week, Lorraine said she was tongue-struck. I mean, we've never had that before. That must have been impressive.
Oh, I was so thrilled and just delighted. You know, just try and keep it up now is a hard going to be hard.
Well, we thought it was great. Pasquale, she's smashing it, isn't she?
She is.
Let's see how you did. The scores are in.
The judges have their scores. Brian Redman.
6.
Lorraine Barry.
6.
Arthur Gullin-Leas.
7.
Yes, Arthur! Arthur's our friend, isn't he? He's our friend, never lets us down. That is a total of 19. Now, as you know, the judges' scores are just part of this story. The dancers still need your vote. So, when we announce the voting lines open later in the show, and only then, you can vote for Nina and Pasquale by calling 1513 717105. Or, of course, you can text Nina to 53125. Get the head up. That was brilliant. Nina Pasquale, everybody!